Hi, John here. Today is Wednesday, the 5th of, is it Wednesday? Thursday, the 5th of January 2017. I'm just posting a few documents on Facebook, quite a bit to update information for the hui up in Waitangi Marae on Waitangi Day, 6th of February. Be going up there on the 3rd of February and having meetings with the chiefs and Kingi Tauruga chief before the 4th, and on the 4th we'll be having other meetings as well in Te Tī Marae. On the 21st of January, we're having a meeting in Pangaru. I'll be attending for the Taumata Kaumātua's meeting and Whakamininga. So I've spoken to Bundy Waitai up there in Kaikoi and told him I'm going. I wasn't going to, but I'm going. I'm taking the bag full of titles and information that you see on Facebook. Today, last night, and questionable. If anybody's got any questions, now's your time to do it. Okay, I just forewarn you that what I put online is admissible in the High Court of Admiralty in London and here in New Zealand's courts. Just to say I won my case in the Auckland District Court because of videos that I run like this, making statements. It's up to you to make a video yourself in the flesh and blood with your voice and your face making statements that you believe are true. It's for anybody to say it's not true. So what you see there in the titles, the Manukau Land Company titles in Glasgow, Scotland, is real. And whatever I'm saying is those titles, not my title. It's those titles that I'm talking to, the Kawharu title on One Tree Hill, and also the Manukau titles that I'm talking to, and the Moai titles that I'm talking to, wrapped up together, okay? So I'm not really speaking for anybody's land, I'm speaking for the King's Bench Court as a surrogate of what the King says in commercial contracts, okay? Get that straight. I'm here online as administrator of the native lands itself, what's stuck on it, and the documents, legal documents that are instruments used as the King's prized possessions in laws. Okay, so that's, I just want to ring Jim Tupi Wikotu, and I always do this because I stick their name to the documents and make it public. Yeah, Jim, it's John Wanoa here. I'm going up to the hui up in Pangaru, and so I thought I'd let you know that if you would go to come up here and we go together, okay? So that's all I ring you for. Let me know, ring me, because I want to make arrangements and everything before then. I spoke to Bundy up there and told him I'm coming. So I'm coming to the hui. I think it's very important at this stage because you have other people that are going to turn up as well as the Maori government, Shunakora. I think the ones from Maniapoto. They're all going to be there, and I think it's fitting if we're there at the same time to make statements in front of each other before Waitangi Day. I won't be getting the hall and because it's booked out in Paihia, so I'm going to take the tent up on the 3rd and stay in that if the marae is not open on the 3rd of February. If so, we'll stay in the marae, but I'll put the tent up and have some hui in there on the 3rd and on the 4th inside Te Tī Marae. Okay, so that's all I wanted to say. Jim, give me a call back and let me know what you are thinking, please. There, that's Jim. I'm making these videos because they are admissible evidence in the High Court of Admiralty in London, for a start, and also in the Auckland District Court here, where I won my case against the CIB police detective, Natalie Flowerdew-Brown, and those landowners on Cook Street. You're in a spot of bother legally now that I've got this lot and the flag behind me, not alone in this. I could carry on ahead by myself, but I prefer not to. I prefer to do it in front of the chiefs, like, as always, all my documents and all my statements are made from marae. Okay, so those people in Pangaroo, I'll be there and face the fact that Kingi and I walked out of Whirinaki Hui because of what was said to Kingi affected me, because both our names are on the documents, the legal documents of commercial contract as commercial landowners gone to Westminster Parliament and the Prime Minister of Britain, Theresa May. It's gone to the Secretary of Defence, Michael Fallon, and it's gone to the Chief of the Navy and Military, Sir Philip Jones. Okay, so they're notified of our intent to bill charge debtor, the New Zealand government, and the Maori iwi authorities on the Crown New Zealand Company and Queen Elizabeth Monarch Sovereign title holdings contracts. Okay, so we are coming from the King's Bench Court contract, commercial contract between the Chief Tera Waikato Wharaherehere Manukau under the Manukau Land Company Scotland titles, jurisdiction of Admiralty of King William IV over these lands, the whole of New Zealand, right? The Manukau Land Company seized all the New Zealand Company, New South Wales, New Zealand Government Company's titles and reissued them under martial law at the time, okay? That's Captain Clendon, James Reddy Clendon, proclaimed the land belongs to the King. Once you say that, once the ship's captain on HMS ships says the land belongs to the King of England, that's the title that I'm talking about here inside the Waitangi Marae King's Bench Native Court. Waitangi Marae King's Bench Native Court hearing. We have two parts of the flag. The 1835 Declaration of Independence flag, 1835, and the New Zealand Government Crown. That date, 1835, 28th of October, and the Government of New Zealand legislated that flag out. So it's got had no mana right up to the 15th of April 2016. When Chief Kingi Taurua and myself, as Sheriff and King William IV surrogate, captain of our ship, proclaimed the land belongs to the chiefs, Hapu, Whakamininga, and not the King of England or the Queen of England. Okay, so that's gone down as legal in front of him and I, and Hohepa Epiā, Epping, and Willie Pater, Comar Tours, on this hui that I'm going to, hopefully with Jim, week or two again, in Pangaroo. So that was legal. We legalized the flag under the Moai Crown, King William the Fourth Trust, and the Whakamininga Native Surname Chiefs. Okay? I make that point clear on this video that your surname has to be male dominant to fit a King's Bench Court title to any native land on the documents, instruments of legal authority. Okay, they're just instruments, they're not the land, it's the instruments that Chief Kingi Taurua is a commercial contract landowner. Okay, we're not talking about a native landowner because there's no such thing as a native landowner. Okay, there's only crown landowners and freehold landowners under a crown of some sort. So the Maori are under the Queen's Bench Court Crown Authority Vice Admiral. And the Moai is a memorial statue standing with King William the Fourth Memorial Statue, Crown Corporate Admiralty title, straight admiral. Okay? Straight admiral title. So in this case, Captain James Reddy Clendon was a surrogate king, the same as what I'm proclaiming to be, and writing it that way, a surrogate King William IV to speak for him in his absence on behalf of the native surname chiefs. Okay, so you've got a group there at the hui calling themselves Whakamininga. Now that's an 1835 Whakamininga. They can't call themselves that because the Whakamininga is still the same flag but two parts, a British part and a New South Wales part. They're talking to the New South Wales part of that flag. It's secondary or inferior to the 1834 Clendon title. Okay, straight from England. As soon as he opened his mouth and said he proclaims the land belongs to the king, he already had the legal instrument documents of deed title to the land that was pre-sold by one Tera Waikato Wharaherehere Manukau in Cambridge, England. Okay, you got that one? That's why Mohi Manukau stand there laughing at everybody all these years in Waitangi Marae and Te Tī Marae, knowing what happened. Okay, he knew what happened and shut his mouth and says nothing because no one was listening to him. And he just did the karakias for the Ratana, you see. So the Ratana followed their own pathways in commerce. Okay, so did King Tohetia in Tainui. They're quite welcome to run their own business in commercial contracts. Whether it's with the Queen or the King is irrelevant as far as we're concerned as native chiefs, surnames. Okay, so the old names that the British picked was the Parapara and the Manukau surnames on their titles. Okay, so the Moai name was a Wānoa name anyway with the Moai statue that they stole in 1868, you see. That period, 1868, was when America lost its sovereignty. It lost its sovereignty to Britain. Right on that date, Topaz picked the Moai statue up, the first Moai to leave that island under Admiralty Court-Martial Law of King William IV. Okay, that was Queen Victoria that stole it for its mana, whenua, title. Okay, so that's the title I'm going on. That one belongs to all you Ngāpuis, Tainui, Ngāti Porou, And Arawa, everyone belongs to the Moai statue right through the world. Okay, all the indigenous people of the world have their own memorial titles, whether it's stone or whether it's wood. The stone seems to have outlasted the wood. But that carving I put there, that Mohi found, or Pākehā found in the Kaipara Harbour and gave it to him, is the title and a parliament set up by the tūpunas, and they hid it in the sand on the beach till such time as it was found and used. That carving that I've put there today, it's been there for a long time, but nobody notices. They don't know one carving to another if you don't know its history. It was made way back in Kāwhiru time. In fact, it's the Kāwhiru period of time of his chieftainship that carving came out. I've got all that history in the Kaipara here from Mohi Manukau. We did all the history in 6 years. We put it all together. All these things you see online have come out of his head, not my head. It's come out of his head and the other chiefs, Hare Otutonga, Matu Tarawa, Richard Kake, and Dawahilni, and all those old people who have gone, have dropped the whole lot on my head. And I don't want it anymore. I want to give it back to you when you know what it means. And the flag, no one seems to have cottoned on what it really means. It's a commercial contract that belongs to the British, that flag. Its symbols, its red cross, is Vatican. That's what Mohi Manukau was, Freemason. 50 years Freemason, you see. He was right at that level. And I went right to that level, and still at that level, to talk in Westminster about all of this that's online. So if anybody's got any problems about what I say, you better put it on my Facebook site so everybody can see, because they're witnessing everything I say is either true or untrue. Right? It's for anybody to say it's not true. I see comments, but I want more than just the comment. I want something in writing there, right there, or a video of yourself saying something in front of the videos I've got there, because videos are very strong and they tell the message straight from your mouth, whether you've got teeth or not like me. It still comes out as raw and in flesh and blood, yourself saying statements that are true if no one says anything, you see. So that's what I use in courts now. Just the video, not documents. I don't have to use documents, but it backs up the documents. In case I make mistakes on documents, it's easy to make mistakes in one word, but not a video. What you say goes. My word against yours. End of quote. Right? If you can't answer, it's because you have insufficient evidence. That's what I won my case on. The court said the police had insufficient evidence. You know why? Because I got too much online. And what the judge said, when my barrister asked him, John wants to say something in the court, and then the judge says, there's no need, it's all on YouTube. End of case. You see? That ended the case. He said, I find you innocent, John Wanoa. And then the police gets on their feet and opens the case up in a new contract after he shut it down. I should have said, oh well, I'm out of here, I'm going now, see you, thank you. But I didn't. I want to see what they were going to do next to catch them committing the fraud. Now I've got all that evidence online right in front of you that even Natalie Flower Dune Brown, detective, can't get out of. They took her out to the Solomon Islands and hid her there. So I won't get her while she's back now. And guess what? She's going into court with a pound note on her head. A trillion pound note on her head. And every other person that got in the way and tampered with the information that I put online. okay, those landowners on Cook Street, I can do this on my own and seize the land, but I prefer to go through the chiefs, okay? The chiefs on the Maori side and the chiefs on the Moai side. So far, I've got 4 chiefs on the Moai side. That's really, really good. Even 4 is enough. If John Key can go and talk for every New Zealander, sell this country out, and get away with it, then leave, the same way as Obama, make it all war, and then leave for the next one to pick up, then that's what John Key did. He's liable, you're liable, John Key, on this video and all the other videos. I'm accusing you of Panama paper fraud, tax evasion fraud, and corruption and treason. Okay? This is what this court hearing's all about. And everyone is joinder or third party to your fraud, back to the Queen Elizabeth's fraud, to Rothschild's bank, funny money fraud, and that money, dollar, American dollar, fiat money, fraud, scam, and cabals, Illuminati, Zionists, UN, IMF, NATO, all of those private companies using King William IV's Admiralty Court Martial Law is in trouble. When we have a court hearing with the real native surname, chiefs, we'll go right through the world. That's why I'm taking my time in this month to prepare for a hearing of all hearings in the world. That's the most powerful court in the world. The most powerful native land court in the world is Waitangi Marae King's Bench Native Court, because it's got a ship of Admiralty beside it with the mast on with our flag, the 1834 Whakaminina flag, and the British flag opposite, and the Union Jack 1902 flag on the top. The Australian Union Jack 1901 is the other ship in the sea flag off the land in the sea of Admiralty, in the sea. You wonder why John Key wanted to change the flag. He did a lot of bad things by trying to put a football flag there in the fern to take a flag of war, Union Jack flag, off as if it was nothing. Cost you, John Key, it's cost you. You got £1 trillion on your head, plus £1 billion trillion note on your head. That's already been given to you by email, and you've acknowledged that you received it by email. Okay, it's online, everybody see. And also the £970 million trillion note against the Queen, the Rothschild banks, Church and State, Vatican City, City of London, these are private companies, Washington DC, US Federal State, Illuminati, cabals, IMF, New Zealand Government, Intuition New Zealand Limited Companies of the Crown Corporation, New Zealand, Queen Elizabeth II, private company, Buckingham Palace, private company, and the 300 royal families, Bank of England, owned by the Rothschilds, Rothschild families, Evelyn Rothschild, okay, those people get the 970 million trillion trillion pound note. And all the gold in Philippines belongs to the Queen Victoria Trust, gets the bill. We are the beneficiaries of that trust in this Whakaminina, the original surname, natives, not Maori. There was no Maori in 1830 to 1837 to 1945. There was no Maoris. There was only native indigene, hapu, chiefs. We put the Moai statue memorial besides the those chiefs. Right? It belongs to them. In fact, it belongs to everywhere in the world where it's gone, where the Queen and her royal family took it and placed it in New York, Washington DC, Brussels, London, France, New Zealand, South Island, Dunedin, and Auckland City, North Island, New Zealand. You see why they did that? They did that for a good reason, to take the native titles all over the world. So that's what this video is for. It's just to update that. I'll try Jim again. I want to see if I can get him. When you're in business, your phone has to ring and answer. There's got to be someone to answer a phone. Now there, he's already got the message, but that's what I mean. Someone should be answering the phone. My phone's always on all the time, and or by email or Facebook. Okay, so that's really what I wanted to say, but I'm just run through on the Facebook site. I've just put up the hidden facts of Littlewood Treaty that will sink the New Zealand government and its corrupted Maori title treaty documents. For legal information, there was no such tribe as Maori in 1830 to 1840 through to 1945 when Maori first appeared on Maori Land Court titles. So Maori, Moai Crown, King William IV, surrogate king, that's myself, and the Whakamininga Grand Jury will open this case to the indigenous countries of the world affected by what we say as Moai Tahitian commercial landowners and not Pākehā Maori iwi fraud landowner trustees. Are you listening? I will drop the original titles in front of Prime Minister Bill English and the New Zealand Navy Chief as third-party trustees, now facing the British Navy Chief's first party to the Moai Crown King William IV Trust and its Whakamininga Native Hapu Indigene male dominant surname chiefs and grand jury and sheriff on the Waitangi Day, 6th of February 2017, as the second party. I meant to put that in as second party. Hold on a second. Hapu Indigene male dominant surname chiefs, second party. That's the trouble with documents. You can miss anything, but not when you say it on a video. Okay, so that's what I've just said. The captain of any British Navy ship proclaims under the King's Admiralty title any native lands of countries he alienates is the property, prized possessions of the King of England in our period of time between 1830 and 1837, King William IV private contract of Admiralty Court Martial Law jurisdictions. The Littlewood Treaty linked New Zealand to America to its commercial landowner King William IV, King of England, Britain, UK at that time of our contract native chief and King William IV. So that's what I've put there. It's better to say it on the video. And from then I start dropping in a few documents of title. I see there's, I'll read this out. I'll read what Kahi Harawira has said on my Facebook site. When you make comments on my Facebook site, they are actually admissible in the High Court of Admiralty in London. Now, you can't go there without an authority of mass protections and titles behind it, okay? So, no offence to you, Kahi. I know you've been watching me all along, but I know your Hatfield American surname by your Pākehā tūpunas. Mine is Rogan Judges, okay, in the Kaipara and Auckland. That's my Rogan Scottish land titles and English surname married into me, Wānoa. They went for Wānoa and Manukau land titles, you see. That's why I'm holding those two titles to that judge in Australia, Rogan, and the Rogan, same John Rogan, and another son Rogan, John Rogan, came to New Zealand and swiped all your titles off you, your New South Wales titles, with your iwi and Maori titles, and whipped them off you. Now, that's what's just about to happen. We're going to whip the whole lot off you again and reissue them to whoever. If it's a Maori government, they get it. You see, not my business. I don't need to know that. I'm just handled the pound note in the bank. The King Tawhiao, Waikato chiefs, pound note back to Te Rā Waikato Whareherehere Manukau in Maunga Tautari, Waikato.